I wanna fold clothes for you. I wanna make you feel good. Baby, I wanna do the right thing. Feel so much better than the wrong thing. I say I wanna fold clothes for you. I wanna make you feel good. Baby, I wanna do the right thing. Feel so much better than the wrong thing. I wanna fold clothes for you.
You know when you're like looking for something? Room is fine, it looks chill, looking for something, and boom, you mess up the entire room because you were looking for it. I'm not saying that's what happened here, but it's kind of what happened here, you feel me? Dana was getting ready this morning, and she wanted me to help her find an outfit. You know, low-key, low-key, I can rock this, low-key. But yeah, she wanted me to help her, you know, find clothes, but there's the clash, there's her taste, and there's my taste, and then there's will she like it? Will she wear it? So I was going through mad stuff, like, so I completely dirtied up the room, and it was just a lot this morning. I wanted to make sure that she could come back to a clean room. Just responding to some comments from the video that I just posted, it had me thinking, like, first of all, thank you guys for all the support all this time. Did I think I would be here at this point? Honestly, nobody's asking me these questions. I'm asking you these questions, whatever. But did I think I would be here, 40,000 subscribers at this point, you know, at this place in my life, working at Fresh Cut, all this? Honestly, no, I did not. I thought it would be a lot further along, honestly. I thought I'd have, like, by this time, have over 100,000 subs, have my own barber's table. When I first started this whole journey, I wasn't sure where I would go, what I was going to do, where the journey would take. But I just thought it would be so cool that no matter where I went, if I documented it, just to be able to look back and see it and, you know, have people who were able to watch it. Like, there's multiple reasons why I started the barber's journey. And I think, first of all, I learned how to cut hair on YouTube. To me, the Michael Jordan of YouTube tutorials was Vic the Barber. I got his DVD, was watching his stuff. I just thought it was so dope. If I could just cut hair like Vic the Barber, that would be amazing. And I'd be able to cut, you know, people. So part of my goal of watching Vic the Barber was actually being able to have my own YouTube channel as well. I love YouTube. I love making videos and all that. You know, I had so many questions. I'm a curious dude, right? I ask a lot of questions and I investigate a lot. I study hard, and when I'm really interested in something, I go really hard at it. So while watching all these YouTube videos, I felt like a lot of people didn't have the answers I was looking for. Like the reality of barbering. Like as a person in high school, I wasn't sure if I was able to do this for real. Like if I was able to have a real life, you know, support myself and all those things. Like I had belief in myself, but would I be able to get that from barbering and all that? So I figured we're gonna see, you know, we're gonna check it out, we're gonna try it out and see what's up. Rather than choose something that makes money that I really don't like, find something that I really like and find out how to make that make money. That way I'd be living a life I want to live instead of being controlled by wherever the paycheck's at. You know, people think a lot of money is freedom. A lot of money can be very crippling for some people.
I wanna fold clothes for you. Woke up this morning feeling like the best version of me. So happy I walked in the living room and saw you all alone on the couch just napping. I see a lot on your plate. Now I must with that weight. I know you're tired, so.
As I grew, the dream like kind of expanded, kind of changed. Like I literally named it the Barber's Table to try and create a community of barbers that shared honestly with each other what's happening in the industry. No knock to people who do like celebrity barbering and stuff. It's just not my thing. Like I don't care about who's in my chair, as in like the quality of person per se. More so, I focus more on the quality of service I provide that person, making them feel like a celebrity rather than trying to make me feel like one. Which is why, like, when I meet people, it's really cool to see you guys in real life. Like, oh, it's the Barber's Table. Like, you know, it's real dope, and I love having conversations, because who the hell doesn't? You know, who doesn't want to meet the people who watch the videos? But I care more about how these videos have helped you in life rather than how cool it is to be known. You know what I mean? Like, ask a question on Instagram. Like, what do you want to see in these videos? How's married life? This is married life, bro. It's married life, bro. Being married is much like, it's no different than anything else. It's learning how to be a team, learning how to support where it's needed, grow together, and improve the world the best way that you know how. That's exactly what I'm here for. I don't know if it's just me, but one thing I really don't like is like fake deep, you know? Like really like That word manifest, bro, I put it on Instagram one time, but like, I really hate tropes and sayings that like don't really mean anything, don't really help anybody, but they kind of just say it to sound like they're deep. Manifest your destiny. Like, most people who say that don't even really know what it means. You want to be successful? Just think about it. Like, no, like, that's not how it works. And that's never how it worked. And I don't know why people continue to do it. It's like, you want to become smart, you want to live the life you want to live, read a book. If all it took was to read a book, why do people that are well-read have no money? How can a person with a PhD become homeless? Because there's more to it. You're not answering the right questions. You're not asking the tough ones. You're just answering the surface ones, trying to build up your image rather than actually help people. So when I see that in the barber industry, I get really frustrated. And instead of like calling these people out and like, cause that doesn't really, I don't really see that as helpful. Seeing somebody who's like really being fake deep, really calling them out. All I gotta do is put out the real, cause what's gonna happen is people are gonna recognize when somebody is real and being authentic and telling the truth rather than trying to save themselves and pose. Like, I hate posers, bro. You won't see any posing on here. I know it's difficult to really be your true self, but what the barber's journey is and always has been, it's been about not being afraid of being authentically you. That's why I post videos and tell you what's happening. It's better to share when you're going through something than to tell what you've gone through, because what you're relying on when you tell what you've gone through is your perception of it and how you want people to view it. I've been telling somebody factually what's happening right now and allowing them to create their own idea of what is happening. Honestly, my hair looks crazy and I just haven't been dying. It was like the first step to really trying to put more work into it. But I've been slacking. I need to get a cut. If y'all trying to see a self-cut video, drop a like, drop a comment. Let your boy know, man. Mad slow. Went from here from 1 to 9, like 4 people. From 1 to 9, that's like 2 hours of work, bro. A little over 2 hours of work, but here for 9 hours. You know, happens sometimes. It's not really frequent, but when it happens, I wish I can fake and act like, you know, I'm booked all the time. I do okay right now. But what I will say is when I don't have anybody, I was able to spend a lot of my time editing. I like the ability to maximize time. Like, I don't know what you guys' opinion is on like doing other work while you're a barber, because I know some people are big on, if you're a barber, like you only do that. Like, you're only a barber. My vision of barbering, I'm not married to barbering. It's not even something I believe I'll do for the rest of my life. So I believe in making money multiple different ways, and that's what I want to learn how to do. Because there's more value in a person than just one thing. Like, you do more than, you can walk, you can run, you can jog, you can crawl, you can jump. Some people try and keep that within barbering or keep that within hairstyling. Like, you can keep themselves boxed in because somebody said that's what you have to do. For me, like, I cut hair. I like videography. I like photography generally right now. That's like a typical, a lot of people are confused at the improvement of price for barbering, why it's so expensive now. I think it's because we've evolved. Not evolved, we don't just charge more because we charge more. We charge more because we do more now. Like, there's a time when fading wasn't a thing. There's a time when, like, you could be a professional barber and not know how to fade. You know, nowadays, if you're a professional barber and you don't know how to fade, you're not making a living. You just can't. You're not able to fade and do that, you're not making a living, you know? If you live in this area, New Jersey, and you don't know, like, New Jersey, New York area, you don't know how to fade, like, find a place out there where barbering isn't big, or, you know, you don't have much competition, or you don't need to do as much. If you want to be a really dope barber, you have to know how to do a lot of things, and you also know how to market yourself well. You also need to know how to, like, you need to understand Instagram, photos, video, freaking email marketing. Like, you know, you need to know how to do a lot. And it's turning into, like, if you're a barber, you might low-key need to have your own product. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, basically, barbers cost as much as they do now because the demand to do more is higher as well. Clipper companies are recognizing that. Instagram is recognizing that. Like the price for clippers are going up, the price for Instagram ads are going up, the prices for all these things, the value is going up. Much like the progression of basketball. You could be a professional basketball player in the 60s, maybe the 70s, and not know how to put the ball in between your legs. There's not one guard in the NBA that can't like put the ball in between their legs. It's gonna get to the point where like there's not one guard in the NBA who can't dunk. Like, you know what I mean? Like, dunking at a certain point was banned. Now we got people jumping over Chance and dunking. Like, you know what I'm saying? Still losing, but you know, it's neither here nor there. What a fade was back in the day, like some people were going against fading and that coming in. Some people were going against electronic clippers, motorized clippers instead of using your hand. Some people don't even think you should use clippers, you should use shears, like, you know, but like clearly the development of barbering is going in a certain direction. Right now, that development is enhancements. Enhancements, hair units. Now these are things that were looked down upon 10 years ago. 10, or maybe even 5, like maybe 5, I'd say like 5, 6 years ago, definitely 10 years ago. When I came in the barber game, you talked about how much you didn't use enhancements. Now, you're talking about how well you can use enhancements. You know, like, it changes. So you gotta really pay attention.